25th of January, all the Egyptian people went to the streets to say freedom, freedom. We want democracy. We don't want any more this regime.
So nobody, everybody left work, everybody left school, yeah. Everybody left home, and they just...
And sat in Tahrir Square for the 18 days till Mubarak left the country.
You were talking about how, and we knew this, how people were losing eyes from rubber bullets, how the camel force came in and were whipping and beating people. What gave you guys the courage to stand up against that regime, that brutality?
Because we all together in Tahrir Square, we feel safe with each other. We feel that we are more than them. Mm-hmm. The policemen are very cruel for us, and they shut the youth, and they use many people a lot of their eyes. But we insist to make our dream true.
So you found that you have power and strength in numbers, and there was just millions of you or more of you than there are of them.
This is our power, that we are millions in the streets.
And that's how it was accomplished, getting everybody in the streets and then everybody working together.
Yeah.
And it wasn't, like you said, it wasn't just workers, it was everybody. It's students, it's families, it's children.
Yes.
A coalition building.
Yes.
When I was sitting and sleeping in the Capitol in Madison, Wisconsin, we were sleeping there one night, and then 20 pizzas, 40 pizzas started getting delivered. And they were delivered and bought and paid for by somebody in Tahrir Square. Again, we were humbled by that and just amazed that someone would even be thinking of us at a time when people were losing their lives.
And, yeah.
You know, this isn't a question. I'm just telling you, we're very, very grateful and humbled by those kinds of actions. And we looked at you for inspiration in the beginning weeks of our struggle and throughout it. Even though the comparison is so minimal, you're a huge inspiration to us in Madison.
Yeah, I think Egypt sent a message to all the world that everything is possible to do. If we dream and if we work together in a systematic way, we can do anything we hope for.
Could you were talking about how you use social networking, and we use social networking to occupy our capital. How did you guys use social networking to occupy Tahrir Square?
Through the Facebook and Twitter.
Yes.
We create an event for the Revolution 25, and we set the places, the demonstration will go there, and every day we update the event and we update the movement and the places, so everyone can have a look on this page and then go to the places of demonstration. And we collect money, we collect food, we collect clothes through this Facebook page. We need money, we need the clothing, we need food for people in Tahrir Square now. So I left my phone number and I left my address, and people called me to pay money, pay clothes to the people who sit in Tahrir Square.
And then you delivered it.
You
picked it up and delivered it right in. That's amazing. That's amazing.
40% of the Egyptian people under the poverty line, and most of the education youth didn't have any job. So we have no choice to remove this regime. This regime is taking all of our money, all of Egypt's money. So we decide to work together to collect each other through the social media, Facebook and Twitter. To come, to enter the streets in one day, so to remove this regime.
Supports Wisconsin workers.
And it's great. Tahrir Square. This.
Yes. So we were circulating that around. We were really humbled by it.
In Wisconsin, they had this sign saying, "Fight
like an Egyptian."
Yes, absolutely. Yeah.